going on, guys? Sinjin Halfdunk here with Team Absolute Awesome. And who are we here today, sir?
Bryce Johnson.
And what did you do, Bryce?
I topped the Prosperity Tournament at CM Games Cedar Bluff.
With what?
Salad, no dressing.
What? What?
Yeah.
Show it to me.
It's the good, brother.
Show it to me.
I got this nice Prosperity.
Good job on your Prosperities.
Yeah, man. Three Buffalo, best normal summon in the deck. You can tidying this, bounce it. I'm gonna draw two. It's best card. Three Foxy, pair it with it. You draw salads, you can discard it. It's really nice. Also just a good normal summon to let you go into Staleo. I was playing three spinny, but now I play two because I found it kind of clunky and it just wasn't the optimal ratio. I wanted to play two. And then the one-ofs, Gazelle, Jaguar, and Falco. I know a lot of salad players opt to play two Jaguar, but if you get it out of the deck quick enough, drawing off Dugarris, Desires, Staleo, and just how often you have Signet Mining Circle, you can get both of these out of the deck before you ever need a Desires to do anything else. And this really isn't super crucial, but it's a good card. So that was the main engine. Kind of my extenders were 3x Zed. I play this because I play two rank 4s in my extra deck, which we'll get to here in just a minute. Hand traps, we played a lot. We played 3 Nib. This was so sacky every game. 3 Ash, 3 Veiler, and then 2 Bell. I lose hard to Revolt, so yeah. this card's just OP. Never played a Tri Brigade player today, so that was kind
of
cracked.
Yeah,
played,
none of the Tri Brigades had a good
played
day today.
2 Prank Kids, which was kind of sacky. Yeah, it was kind of sacky. 2 Dragon Links, and then Zombie and a couple other things.
All the decks you don't want to play?
All the control decks, all the control decks. So yeah, I was like 20-something monsters. It's 42-card main deck because I play the 2 Bell. I was just going to play 40, but I just really wanted Bell in the main.
Right.
On the spells, 1 Sanctuary, 1 Circle, 1 Will. I know some people like to play 2 Will, but I kind of just send this turn 2 as a follow-up, add it back with Wolf, and if I'm trying to extend. But if you open it, it can let you play through Nib. But Buffalo is just better than trying to like extend with this because if you can get Gazelle or like a way to summon Staleo, you don't really like need this. So it's more of just like a follow-up. It's just like a really nice just extra extender into the deck. So those are the one-ofs. 3 Mining lets you just search all your stuff. This card's cracked. 2 Desires. We were playing 2 Desires Upstart in the 40-card list, but I decided to cut Upstart because you're essentially playing 39 cards with 2 Desires, so your Desires are always going to basically be terrible if you do that. So playing this with 42 kind of made the consistency of Desires a little better. I never drew it off the other, so it was really nice. And then the one Called By, enough said, this card needs a
Yeah, Called By is insane.
Called By is insane.
Yeah,
great card. 1 Rage, 1 Roar. I know some people play 2 of this. I even considered siding one of each, but it's just not necessary. These cards are just blowouts. 3 Imperm, the other hand trap we played. And then I was playing the Rivalry of Warlords build to like kind of play the more control variant, but shout out to John Campo and Alex Padgett and a couple other guys. I played 3 Strike in the main. This was just blowout. I would side it in game 1, leave it in game 2, you know, break a board, set it, they try to extend, strike, they lose. So it was really nice. So yeah, 42 card main, extra deck was 15, 3 Bay Links, 3 Wolf. I like 2 Leo. I don't like the Opalooza build or like the Splash Mage combo. I think that you have to play this and then God card's back in the deck, baby.
Oh yeah. I feel like all Opalooza does now lately is just get impermed.
Yeah,
imperm
and like
bait.
The theory behind it is like with Heat Leo, you can also just clear back row, but then also this is just a pseudo extender if you're out of Wolves or you don't have a way to establish like 2 monsters update under Lingerevo, which was also like a really sacky card I played today, that you can make transcode update under this and then link this with update into an access code and co-link it to trans, so it can't be like Veiler or Imperm.
Oh, sick.
Which is really nice. So you play around like Veiler, Imperm, and a lot of cards that could like shut this down, like Conquistador, or like any of those things. So like, it's just really nice, can't be destroyed. And then Staleo is just really good, bouncing cards off the field.
Do you care if I speak about Strike for 2 seconds?
Go ahead, go ahead.
The reason we chose to do Strike instead of Rivalry is because Rivalry is really good against just 2 matchups, whereas Strike's really good against almost every matchup. Secondly, it makes Nib dead.
It does.
Yeah. We don't like Nib.
Yeah, Nib's kind of strong.
And like honestly too, like we liked Rivalry because if we did get Nibiru, we would just set it. And our token was always really small. So like we just let them beat over it. And then like if we're going against Pranks, just draw face, flip it. They're stuck on rocks.
Right.
Like, if they can summon Roxy's all day, but if they go into Meowmew, they can't summon all of that. So it's just bad. On to the other links and the other cards in the deck. Lingaribo, if you let my Buffalo summon resolve and I have Exceed and you're playing Tri Brigade, I'm going to kill you. Because I'm going to summon this, summon two, and then I'm going to link. This card just negates traps. This card's really slept on. I think every solid player should play this card. Update transcode, access code combo. We were always OTKing in German, so we were never doing it in English. I really like Update Jammer's secondary, like, battle phase effect. So, like, this will come up a lot during the Despia matchups next format when Despia gets all the new support. When your Cyber Monster battles, it can negate all of their card effects on the field and restore monsters to their original attack and defense. And this is really nice because the Despia Fusion Monster can make everything zero. And that's really problematic when you're trying to access Code Swing for game, because they're just going to make it zero before you pop it. And then you can't kill them and they blow you out with Fallen About Bass.
Right.
So I feel like that's going to come up. Update's kind of insane. And then two rank fours I played Dugarris, like I said. This card is just so good. Draw two, summon one from grave. You know, you can do pretty much anything. Double the attack, and then Dweller. Made this against Pranks. They lost. It's just so good. Dweller's really good. We were playing Splash Mage. I know Ocampo was playing Salad as well today. But we were talking about playing Splash Mage. We cut this, like, this morning, and then we were like, let's put this back in. I'm really glad we played this.
Yeah, Dweller's good. Super
good. Side deck is pretty standard, honestly, I feel like, at this point. One Pankratops, drew it a lot. Droll, this was insane against Dragon Link.
Such a good card.
And against Pranks, it's honestly really good. Three Lancia, this card's really good against Dragon Link, Tribe, VW, even the PK Phantom Knight deck.
That was, you know, a lot of that.
Yeah, stopping them from just doing stuff, it's really good. My goo in the side deck was the Scythe Sanctum package. This card blew people out. This card was really good. It's nice too, because, like, if you're going against, like, Pranks or somebody that Lightning Storm you, or, like, they Twister you, you know, the theory is, like, you can flip this, they might chain, like, something, or, like, say they Twister you, you just chain this, summon this out, and then you also get a pop. So it can just be pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah, it can be pretty good. So I like that a lot. And then backer removal, three twin and feather duster.
Broke.
Never resolved this today, but twin, drew it against Pranks.
And seems good.
Draw phase. Seems good. It's pretty good. So yeah, that was the deck. It was really awesome. Matchups were pretty great. I had a draw against Dragon Link round three, but one out from there. Yeah,
We take those though.
Shout outs to Jonathan Ocampo, Zach Yoder, Alex Padgett, everyone at Team Net, and everyone at Corner Magic. You know, really supportive, really glad the deck worked out today. Super happy to get the pot.
Well, congratulations, man. I really had high hopes. I felt like you were going to do well, and you did exactly what I thought you would, man.
Appreciate
good job, man. Love you guys.
Appreciate it, brother.